फ्रेंड्स दिस इज नेक्स्ट टॉपिक फ्रॉम 12th फिजिक्स सिलेबस फ्रॉम HSC बोर्ड. ओके सो दिस इज 5th टॉपिक दैट इज ऑसिलेशंस. ओके द कंपल्सरी मार्क्स इन द क्वेश्चन पेपर आर 4, मार्क्स विथ ऑप्शन आर 5. ओके सो इन ऑसिलेशन वी आर गोइंग टू स्टडी सो मेनी फिनोमेनास. टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू सी सम बेसिक टर्म्स, बेसिक कंसेप्ट्स रिलेटेड टू ऑसिलेटरी मोशन और ऑसिलेशंस. ओके सो बिफोर दैट वी विल स्टार्ट विथ पीरियोडिक मोशन. इन डे टू डे लाइफ वी कम अक्रॉस सो मेनी टाइप्स ऑफ मोशन. दैट इज फर्स्ट वन इज पीरियोडिक मोशन, मोशन दैट रिपीट्स इटसेल्फ आफ्टर इक्वल इंटरवल ऑफ टाइम. इट इज नथिंग बट पीरियोडिक मोशन. फॉर एग्जाम्पल मोशन ऑफ हैंड्स ऑफ क्लॉक. सो द मोशन ऑफ हैंड्स ऑफ क्लॉक दैट मीन्स घड्याळाचे काटे. द मोशन इज रिपीटेड आफ्टर इक्वल इंटरवल ऑफ टाइम. सेकेंड एग्जाम्पल इज मोशन ऑफ मून अराउंड अर्थ. इट इज ऑल्सो रिपीटेड आफ्टर इक्वल इंटरवल ऑफ टाइम. इट इज नथिंग बट पीरियोडिक मोशन. वन मोर टर्म आई विल इलस्ट्रेट दैट इज ऑसिलेटरी मोशन और ऑसिलेशंस. फॉर एग्जाम्पल इफ वी कंसिडर अ पेंड्युलम. सो पेंड्युलम, सिंपल पेंड्युलम, इट इज नथिंग बट हेवी मेटेलिक स्फियर सस्पेंडेड टू रिजिड सपोर्ट बाय मीन्स ऑफ लाइट इनएक्सटेंसिबल स्ट्रिंग. वेन द बॉब इज डिस्प्लेस्ड फ्रॉम इट्स मेन पोजिशन एंड रिलीज इट परफॉर्म्स टू एंड फ्रो मोशन अबाउट इट्स मेन पोजिशन और इक्विलिब्रियम पोजिशन. सो इट इज नथिंग बट ऑसिलेटरी मोशन. अनदर एग्जाम्पल इज नीडल ऑफ सिलिंग मशीन, शिलाई मशीन ची सुई. सो इट मूव्स अप एंड डाउन अबाउट इट्स मेन पोजिशन. सो इट इज नथिंग बट ऑसिलेटरी मोशन. मोशन ऑफ प्रॉन्ग्स ऑफ ट्यूनिंग फॉर्क, दिस इज ट्यूनिंग फॉर्क, दीज आर प्रॉन्ग्स ऑफ ट्यूनिंग फॉर्क. सो दीज प्रॉन्ग्स मूव्स टू एंड फ्रो अबाउट इट्स मेन पोजिशन, इक्विलिब्रियम पोजिशन. सो दिस इज नथिंग बट ऑसिलेटरी मोशन. सो द बॉडी परफॉर्मिंग ऑसिलेटरी मोशन, वाइब्रेटरी मोशन इज नोन एज ऑसिलेटर और वाइब्रेटर. द मोशन वन सच सेट ऑफ मूवमेंट्स. सपोज द बॉब स्टार्ट्स फ्रॉम दिस एक्सट्रीम पोजिशन, इट मूव्स टुवर्ड्स मेन पोजिशन, इट मूव्स टुवर्ड्स अदर एक्सट्रीमिटी, अगेन टू मेन पोजिशन एंड दिस पोजिशन. सो दिस इज वन सेट ऑफ मूवमेंट. One set of such movements is known as one oscillation. Okay, now we will see detail about this motion, oscillatory motion or oscillations. Now consider one more example of oscillatory motion. See here, consider a metallic block. Okay, it is placed on horizontal surface. This surface is frictionless surface. Okay, that means the block can move here and there without any friction. Okay, so this block is placed on frictionless horizontal surface. A spring is taken. One end of the spring is attached to rigid support and other end of the spring is attached to this metal block. Now, if this is its mean position or equilibrium position or it is relaxed position, the spring is relaxed. Okay, if the block is displaced from its mean position towards right, in this position, see here, the block is displaced from its mean position. The displacement is x here. So, this position of the spring is stretched position. So when the spring is stretched toward, displaced from its mean position and it is released, the block moves to and fro motion about its mean position. So these are nothing but oscillations. The block performs oscillations about its equilibrium position. Now we will see details of this oscillatory motion. Now see the first case. This is stretched condition of the spring. The bob or the block is displaced towards right. The block is displaced towards right from equilibrium position. Displacement is x here. So the spring tries to bring the block to its mean position. Because of its elastic properties, the spring tries to bring the block to its original position. So it exerts force on the block. That means the restoring force is developed within the spring, which tries to bring the block towards its equilibrium position. That means for this is force is nothing but restoring force. If the displacement is more, restoring force will be more. That means I will write here, the magnitude of this restoring force is directly proportional to displacement. If the displacement is more, more restoring force is developed within the spring, it will try to bring the block to its mean position. Suppose in the this is relaxed position, in the next position, if the block is moved towards left, that means spring is compressed. Then also the spring tries to move the block towards its equilibrium position. That means here the displacement is towards left and the force is trying to move the block towards right. So I can say that here also the force is directly proportional to displacement. Now we will see about its direction. Okay, when the block is moved towards right, the spring tries to bring it towards left. Okay, when the block is moved towards left, the restoring force in the spring tries to bring it towards right. That means this force is oppositely directed to displacement. Okay, this magnitude of restoring force is directly proportional to displacement, but the force, this restoring force, is oppositely directed to displacement. In this case also, this is displacement. When the bob is displaced towards extreme position, the system tries to bring it towards its mean position. Okay, in this way, this restoring force is developed within the body, which is directly proportional to displacement. It is oppositely directed to displacement. Here, F is proportional to minus X. Instead of proportionality, I can take constant K into X. So, F is equal to minus KX. Okay. Now, because of this restoring force, acceleration is acting on the block. So, this acceleration A is equal to F divided by M. It is equal to minus KX divided by M. So, if I write minus K by M into X. So, from this equation, it is seen that acceleration acting on the block is also directly, magnitude is directly proportional to displacement and it is oppositely directed to displacement. Okay, so the motion here, oscillatory motion, is along the straight line. So it is nothing but linear simple harmonic motion. Now we can define linear simple harmonic motion is in such way that linear periodic motion of a body in which force or acceleration is directly directed towards mean position and its magnitude is directly proportional to displacement. See here, in linear SHM, force is directly proportional to displacement and is oppositely directed to displacement. So It is nothing but linear, simple harmonic motion. So, see here, if we consider example of pendulum. So, see here, it is its mean position or equilibrium position. When the bob is displaced towards extreme position, so at this position its velocity becomes momentarily zero, because as the displacement is increased, the restoring force is increased, which decreases the speed of the bob, and at this position, at the extreme end, its speed becomes momentarily zero. Again, the bob moves towards the mean position, and here the displacement is decreasing. That means x value of x is decreasing, and here the force is directed towards its mean position. Acceleration is also directed towards mean position. So its speed goes on increasing, and the body continues to move towards other extremity instead of being velocity zero. So here, in case of linear, such a force or acceleration is directly proportional to displacement, and it is directly proportional to displacement, and its direction is towards the mean position. So it is nothing but linear SHM. Now we are going to see differential equation of linear SHM, linear simple harmonic motion. Okay, we have seen that linear simple harmonic motion is nothing but periodic motion in which force or acceleration is directly proportional to displacement, and it is oppositely directed to displacement, and it is nothing but linear SHM. So here, force is directly proportional to displacement and is oppositely directed to displacement. So here, instead of proportionality, I will write F is equal to minus sign, as it is constant, K into X. F is equal to minus KX. So it is according to definition of linear SHM. Now, according to Newton's law, we know that F is equal to MA. So this is equation 2. Okay, I will combine equation 1 and 2. Therefore, M into A is equal to minus KX. So see here, we know formula for velocity. Velocity is nothing but dx by dt, change in displacement with respect to time. We know acceleration is dv by dt, that is change in velocity with respect to time. Okay, acceleration is change in velocity with respect to time, but it is nothing but d dt of, instead of v, I will substitute here dx by dt. Instead of v, I have substituted dx by dt, and hence it is nothing but d2x by dt square. Acceleration is d2x by dt square. So I will substitute here, therefore m into d2x by dt square is equal to minus kx. So m I will take to this side. So d2x by dt square is equal to minus k by m into x. So I will take all the term towards left side. Therefore d2x by dt square plus k by m into x is equal to 0. So this is differential equation of linear SHM. D2x by dt square plus k by mx k by m into x is equal to 0. Differential equation of linear SHM. Now, if I substitute instead of k by m omega square, then the equation will be d2x by dt square plus omega square x is equal to 0. We know that omega is angular velocity. K by m is equal to omega square. This is also one more form of differential equation.